Well, lots of you have sent questions into our chat room. And Pat, this first one is from Kathy, who says, my husband is addicted to porn. We've prayed about it, gotten counseling, but his addiction has gotten worse, not better. We've managed to cope with this for years, but I'm getting worried. Soon we'll be going on a tropical vacation, and I'm worried that he's going to spend his time leering at other girls in bikinis. What should I do?
Better to be leering at real girls in bikinis than mythical girls in porn. He's got to be delivered. There's an addiction. There's a spirit of lust that has come upon him. And the only way to deal with it is to bind Satan's power and cast that thing out. You need the same kind of thing that you would do if you had somebody who's involved in heroin addiction. And you have an intervention and people come, you've got to confront him with it and lay it on the line. You can't continue this. And I might add, if you continue in a relationship with somebody like that, you're becoming an enabler. And you've got to stand up and say no more, all right?
And you need some accountability, too. You know, just counseling through something like that is, unless you want to change.
There's got to be intervention where there's you rebuke Satan. It's
absolutely
a spirit of lust that has come upon that man. He's got to be set free. All right.
And this is Linda, who says, my brother stole more than $1 million from my mother and me. My mom had to move in with me. She's not forgiven him, but I have. We're having a hard time making ends meet because of the missing money. My husband told me to forget it and move on, but I want to confront him. My brother doesn't seem like he's sorry for what he's done to us. Do I obey my husband or confront my brother?
Look, it's your call. I don't know what to tell you. It's your own family situation. You say he stole your money. You know, it'd be nice to forgive, but I honestly think that in a thing like that, there are law courts, and I think he should be brought to justice. I mean, he's...
Yeah, she doesn't say how the money was stolen. You
well,
know,
I know. It's very difficult, mm-hmm. Terry, but that's why you don't know what to counsel. But I just believe in a situation like that, it isn't enough to just forgive and forget. He's not asking for forgiveness. And the Bible says if they ask for forgiveness, give it to them. He's not asking for it. And I think there needs to be a certain amount of justice. You and your mother have been impoverished because of what this man has done to you. And I think he should pay some of the money back. And so, but I don't know the circumstances. So,
yeah.
But in my opinion, it would be one of those things where you ought to get a good attorney and see what you can do about, you know.
Find out what your rights are in
the situation. Jerking his chain a little bit. Mm-hmm. All right.
And this is Bally, who says, I've been married for a year, and recently my husband has told me that he wants a second wife. He already has a girlfriend and says he wants to marry her. He doesn't see anything wrong with his decision. Am I still bound by the marriage vows we said?
Not if he's catting around that way. If he really wants a second marriage, let him have her, and,
yeah.
And that becomes, you're out. But, I mean, that's what the Bible says. Adultery is a ground for divorce.
Well, he sounds like he thinks bigamy is all right.
Well,
that's odd.
There are many people, Muslims, think it's okay. Four wives is cool. And the old Mormons used to think a number of marriages, and they have those sister wives and all that.
Yeah.
It's your call, but in my opinion, I'd say no way. And according to the Bible, your husband has obviously hasn't grown up yet. He sounds to me like he's terribly immature.
Yeah, they've only been married for a year.
Yeah, I mean, it's weird.
It's crazy.
But you don't have to stay in a thing like that.
No.
All right.
This is Amanda, who says, my husband has always been an excessive spender. The Lord has blessed him with promotions, but we still struggle because of his frivolous ways. Every time he gets extra money, he spends it on himself. I even began using coupons to save money. I've tried to talk to him, but he gets mad and walks away. After 10 years of this and 3 children, I'm fed up. I just don't know what else to do since paying bills isn't a priority to him. Help.
My dear, you married him. I keep saying that. You married him. You knew what you were dealing with. And here again, it's immaturity. And maybe counseling would work. I don't know what else to say. Sometimes you threaten if you don't shape up, or else you just say, look, I'm going to stop marital relations with you until such time as you begin to show responsibility in relation to finances. But he will cripple you all for the rest of your lives. You will be financial cripples. And what's going to happen is you'll wind up in old age and you won't have any money. So, I mean, it's a terrible thing, but yes, they're immature people. That's what we've been talking about, is the number of immature people, and, you know, they need to grow up.